Hello, hi, how are you today? In this video, I want to talk to you about how highly emotional this energy is in this time here in April. There's an eclipse, there's a new moon. In some ways, you could almost say there's always a reason why the energies are pushy or just like, you know, too much somehow. But here's the thing. Things are on the move and things are continuing to ascend, whether people like it or not. There is a major ascension. There are people who are awakened, and a lot of people are getting very overwhelmed with it. Are you one of those people who is feeling overwhelmed with all this stuff? And how would you like to simplify it? And, you know, really, how do you scale it so that it's actually doable for you? So today I want to talk to you about all this emotional stuff, and there are things that are still happening. They're going to happen around you. Just within the past few days, there was a friend who he had a good friend. She lost her son to a drug overdose, even after he had been trying rehab and treatment and stuff, and that's a loss for her. What do you say? It's highly emotional. It's not that people can't feel. That's part of what is happening. We are feeling again. We have to feel. There's an entire spectrum of emotion that we are supposed to feel and yet not throw us off. How do you do that? Wait a minute. How do I do that? How do I actually feel and not feel like I'm going to go off on someone or take a tailspin and fall into a black hole or go into another dark night of the soul? Aha. How do you do that? How do you not get overwhelmed and still do you, like people say, you know, you're taking care of your business, you're still taking care of your responsibilities, you have to do what you need to do. Self-care goes beyond doing your hair and your nails. Self-care is actually, a lot of it has to become emotional regulation. Now, that is made easy through your new twin flame body, but let's dig on that a little bit, right? Sometimes, actually, the world makes me feel like I'm going crazy. Well, you're not crazy, but a lot of this stuff can accumulate to where you don't know which end is up. You don't know what to do first. You lose focus. You feel overwhelmed. You feel sort of brain foggy. You're not getting the right messages or signals. It's a lot. It's a lot to navigate. I help people in three easy steps. Now, these steps may sound like they're easy. It is challenging to get yourself started to actually do them, right? And not only that, I'm going to talk about something that is really, really hard for a lot of people. And that is people that are sick. Okay, and I don't mean like physically sick, like they have a cold. I mean, they're sick. There's something not right. They may be on the spectrum. They may be ASB people or autism people. They may feel like going off, right? And this is a part of including everyone. And yet, because people are different, we're all different, okay? There's no criticism there. But at what point does it just become something that is overwhelming you? How about the people that have someone like that in your vicinity? They get a little obsessive, right? They repeat and repeat and repeat. You have to work with them, or you see people, or they're at the store, or they're in traffic, or whatever. Now, you have an extreme, which is people that are super angry, and they're angry all the time, and they're constantly trying to pick on or provoke or, you know, get a rise out of people. Is that necessary? Don't we have enough problems without people trying to do that to other people? And then you have the other people that are all the way at the other extreme, just internalizing, 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 till they almost want to erase themselves. They've got all their stuff on, they're wearing a mask. Like, they're still doing everything to try and not even be noticed, not take it in. Believe it or not, both those extremes are still empaths. Yeah, how's that for a kicker? Why? Because it affects the electric side of you, your action part. You're either overacting and overreacting, or you are underreacting and withering away, and you're withering on the vine, and you're losing your energy and your focus, and you're getting overwhelmed. This happens to women a lot. Not only that, during these lunar cycles, your actual cycle can be affected. How many people are going into perimenopause? Even if you feel like you're too young for that, that too is an ascension thing. And it's definitely a twin flame ascension thing, because you are going to burn off your former reproductive level that you once were at, and you're ramping that up without the pains and the discomfort and the brain fog and the ditziness and walking into your kitchen wondering what you came in there for. I just recently heard someone, and she took her honey and she put it in the bathroom. She took the jar and put it on a bathroom shelf. And her husband didn't think a thing of it, because he just sort of assumed she was going to do a facial with it. She'd been talking about all this self-care. He didn't even bother correcting it. He didn't even think it was weird. But what was weird for her is she went around and around trying to find the damn jar of honey. Okay. Other people may not want to trigger you. Other people may not even think that they're doing that. And this is why I say the sick stuff. Can you fight with sick people? Well, guess what? Sick people do fight. That's a paradox. People who don't have that kind of mental, emotional regulation, where it comes easily through your body because your light body is going do-do-do-do-do and deflecting these for you. Deflect away the people. There is a third solution. There is not just duality. Like, if they're fighting me, I got to fight back, or I have to defend myself, or I'm just an empath and I'm taking it on. Okay. This is the beauty part of your twin flame body, is that there's a natural balance to it. There's a natural way to feel like there is a protective bubble around you that literally will sift and sort people up and away from you, or worst case, you get like a fairly innocuous person. They may be argumentative, but really no damage is done. There is a progression to this also. Now, I have a couple of friends, and they are in challenging professions, trying to work with people. One works in a school that the town is gang infested. There's a gang for this and a gang for that. And, you know, here's the really weird thing. These are children that she's dealing with. And then they are children burdened with adult stuff, with no recourses and no, like, they don't see anything for their life for the most part. So they're relegated to it. They're resigned. And in fact, that's their normal. They don't know anything else. How do you get people to start with that kind of emotional balance, where they don't have to prove anything? Well, it has to start with those of us who are awakened. This is important. Are you a healer? Okay. Are you a healer? Meaning, are you some, even a type of alternative healer? Are you awakened and you noticed you have sort of healing qualities to yourself? Do you have this and you're wondering, how do I balance and how do I keep my own balance and keep strong even while I'm surrounded, because it feels like we're going down on the Titanic and everyone's grabbing on for dear life? Yeah, it can feel like that. There are things that are happening, and, you know, people are looking to leadership, but leadership, it's like that juggling, you know, or like, did you ever see the circus where they have the spinning plates? As soon as they get to the one on the end and keep that spinning, they've got to go over to the other one. This is up to us as leaders of the energies. In other words, leading energetically for yourself, for your other half, for your family, your children, the people around you in your vicinity. It's really hard if you're not being the captain of your own ship, of your own twindom, of your own light body, whatever you call it. People have different names for it, their aura, Their etheric body, there is actually subsets of several subtle bodies that have to work in harmony together. Okay, and this is some of why this happens at different stages in your journey, because some of those stages are for mental, emotional. And so a lot of times, believe it or not, this will happen right after winter. Why? Because people had a lot of chest, respiratory, upper body inflammations, and then it makes it the perfect timing to start letting those emotions filter up and start getting people balanced, only if they work within the mode that is really truly for this, because there's two of you balancing. So, you know, some people are like, I don't know why it is at work. I am just always the person that people seem to lean on. They tell their troubles to. They feel better. I feel worse. I just don't even know what to do about it sometimes. They see that I'm strong. They see that I strive for excellence, but I just can't seem to get people to back off. And I get tired. By the end of the day, sometimes I feel like I haven't even done what I'm being paid for. And all I did was, like, you know, do this work as a junior psychologist. Well, there is a solution. And believe it or not, it starts right at the beginning of your day. That is a part of this where I teach you how to do the stuff at the beginning of the day, where your own soul will help sift and sort that stuff. If it's something of interest to you, it'll come in. It cannot penetrate you. That sounds so interesting. That's how it feels sometimes, like everything's seeping in, creeping in, penetrating, bogging me down. You know, I'm just not like a wind up and go, and I gotta do for everybody. I understand that. Yes. You have not just a dream, you have a journey, and you're going places with it. You really are here to be with someone. You are here to be someone, and you're here to do something, no matter how small or big that is, no matter how big or small. And there are small things like that, like the things that people will tell you. Oh yeah, people just say, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. People just say, it's just talking. People just say, oh, well, they're just looking for a sympathetic ear. I am tired of it. Yes, this is the raw, ugly side of empathy. This is a dark side of being an empath, okay? When it feels painful for you, when it feels like other people's stuff, other people's energy is just a shocking drain, okay? And you don't need it. And they're not doing anything about it. What are you supposed to do, right? Oh, absolutely. So these are some of the things you need to know. You have sides to your central nervous system. You don't need to be a biology major to figure this out. I'm here to teach it. You have lover sides of you that doesn't need other people's stuff intruding and penetrating and making your life a living hell sometimes. Even if that's your own kids. How do you turn it around? How do you really get to another level where not only are you productive, it actually starts that attunement effect on other people, okay? Even if they're not awakened, you're not here to heal their stuff. Their stuff is supposed to whiz past you. How do you transmute it? I help you to do that, and I help you to learn, and I help you to do it again and again and again. Should you change jobs? Should you come together and there's other family members to deal with, and you're just like, we don't want to just deal with them. We want to be embraced. We want to be applauded. We want them to feel us for who we really are, right? That's what you want. So please know that I have a lot of things to help you with every single stage of your journey, especially if you're not together, because guess what? Here's the thing. Some people that are together, they're relying on that, and they sometimes use their mouths too much. You know what I like to say? Mouths are for kissing. So, but your light body, that's for merging and communing. So let's learn how to do this, do it the right way, Do it where you are adept at it, where it is your nature, it is in your angelic nature, it's making you into a human angelic again, so that you can truly, you have to stop putting on your cape and actually have solutions. Here's another example I use. You know, a lot of people look around and they're saying, you know, a lot of people need help. And yes, they do. But it's like this. It's time for other people to start stepping up. But that means it's time for you to also up level so that you can do more by who you are. That is what you call doing by being. So I hope to see you there. Please check the links below and have a great day. Bye.